Episodes. Fucking Frankenberry cereal. You understand? Dude, this is the... Nobody thinks... Why do you have this cereal, man? Nobody fucks with this. Just me.
I saw it deep in your Instagram that it was the best cereal.
Oh, shit. What deep. Dude, this is crazy.
What about this makes it the best cereal?
Honestly, I think it's nostalgic, to be honest. But it is good. It's good cereal. I don't know. Have y'all had it?
I've never heard of it.
No, what's it taste like?
Huh?
What's it taste like?
You should taste
it. It tastes like Kix with Frank marshmallows in it.
Yeah. A little bit of strawberry. just a piss of strawberry. Just a little bit.
I've never had it.
Yeah. Well, you should get some.
I don't even know the last time I've seen it.
Count Chocula. A lot of people think that black people automatically default to Count Chocula. Nope. It's Frankenberry for me. People assume, but nope. I am a Frankenberry dude, man. Appreciate that.
No problem, man.
Yeah, that's awesome.
Yeah, it was actually really good. Like, I tried it. I was like...
You see what I'm saying?
I ate it. I took the first bite, and I was like, I don't even know how old this is, though. I hope it's good. It was good. It was good. I haven't gotten sick or anything, so...
Why is he getting
strawberries? Is that a current cereal, or is that a...
Oh, this is old.
Okay.
Yeah, it's pretty old.
I think they discontinued it for a while.
I was about to say, we haven't seen it.
Yeah,
in a while.
So the box that I saw was like really old. This looks like an updated version. Like almost like they're like rebooting it, you know?
Yeah. Yeah, this was back
in the day.
This is
like the girl Ghostbusters.
Yeah, because I've never seen them with strawberry fingernails. That's
strawberry fingernails.
That's different.
Yeah, like that's awesome. Al Frankenberry.
Yeah. He does.
He does look like Al Franken.
Dude, that is crazy. Like, he looks like Al Franken.
That's hilarious. Kind of creepy. Yeah.
I wonder if they did that on purpose. Al Frankenberry. That's awesome.
It's an obscure reference for some.
I know, right?
Al Franken. So I know you got smokes and jokes. Yeah. So I was going to give you a joke book and smokes, but I was like, nah, it's too on the nose. This could be a joke book. I saw you play the golf tournament with John Daly.
Oh, wow. Yeah.
What was that like?
The goat. Watching him hit was depressing on my swing, but.
Was he good?
It was awesome. I mean,
because he did it with a cigarette in his mouth.
He did it, cigar in his mouth, barefoot.
Easy.
Drunk as hell.
Damn.
That's
typed
awesome.
Typed it 300 yards right down the center every time. Yeah, he was cool. He's a super nice guy. He's pretty plastered, but you know, to be expected. I mean, he was having a good time.
That's what you want, though, with John Daly, right?
Yeah, I got the experience of meeting him. And, like, well, everything I wanted in him was
that. So you actually, like, met him?
Yeah.
Oh, that's awesome.
Yeah. I don't know if he met me, but I met him.
Yeah, you'll remember it.
Yeah, for sure. That was a fun tournament. We were in, like, this, it was like a John Daly tournament over in Old Natchez, like, right outside of Nashville. And, the people they paired us with, God, I'm gonna forget their name. Dan Feeney,
from Say by or from Boy Meets World, Mr. Feeney.
No.
No, that's what I thought. Yeah.
No, Dan Feeney from I think he's with the Dolphins now. Yeah, and then
Feeney. Every backswing. Yeah.
He does it every time.
I love the Feeney call.
And then the center for the Buccaneers.
Oh, shit.
The guy that, I guess, snaps it to Brady.
Yeah.
Huge guy.
I could never tell you his name.
What's his name? The guy that snaps it to Brady.
They were getting, I don't even know if I can share this, but I hope they don't find me. They were getting hammered to the point where, like, they started trying to tackle us. And, I mean, these are, like, 6'5", 300-pound, at least, linemen.
And they tried to tackle you.
Yeah, I juked one of them, and he fell.
That's hilarious.
And I was like, I can at least put that on my resume.
Yeah,
I juked a lineman.
Didn't get killed by an NFL player.
So you'd be getting ready to drive, and you just hear them, like, getting angry and just start coming at you. They're, like, wrecking their carts into everybody. I'm just like, we're about to get kicked out of this tournament. But it was fun. Me and, you know, Aaron Berg from New York. Yeah. He was the one that got me on that tournament. Otherwise, I would have never been around those people ever. Dude, where did you even find this?
You know, this is weird.
I guess I don't
want to
give away y'all's secrets, but that's badass. Thank you, dude.
Weird stuff on there.
And it's when you had the mullet. Hell yeah. Yeah, cool guy.
Next thing nice. I got you, Matt.
What's this? Oh, Bonnaroo. Oh, was this the year? Yeah. Yeah. Billy Joel.
Billy Joel.
Is that the one year? Have you gone any other time, or is that it?
I've been a few times, but this was...
It was a good year.
One of the few I remember.
That was awesome, man.
Yeah. Oh, yeah, this was the year that I ran into Jeff Ross. I wasn't even doing comedy.
Oh, for real?
Yeah.
Oh, did he get you in a comedy?
Roastmaster?
No. He was just at the festival, like, wandering the grounds. I was like, oh, shit, Jeff Ross?
Oh, wow.
He's That's like, awesome. What's up? And then, like, everybody bombarded me. He's like, look what you did. I was like, I'm sorry. I just recognized you and thought it was cool.
That's how I saw David Taylor. That's how I met him.
Really?
In Atlanta. Not Atlanta. L.A. We were there. And this was last year during the Netflix festival. And he was outside the improv, the Hollywood Improv. Like, he was just standing there smoking a cigarette. And people were walking past him and didn't notice him. And it just freaked me out. Like, nobody noticed him. I was like, what are y'all doing? Like, do y'all not know?
Yeah.
And, like, nobody. They're like, you're a famous comedian? I'm like, dude, come on now. Like, you got to know who to tell.
Did it almost make you, like, question if it was really him?
Absolutely. Because I was like, David. That's how I had to get him to say something to me. Because I was like, David Taylor?
He does dress like he works security
right.
at the comedy festival.
He could have easily been somebody else. And I'm known to do that. Like, I'm known to, like, I've been known to come up to people and be like, hey, you're so-and-so. I'm like, hey, how you doing? I'm like, no, I'm not that person. And then it's always awkward. Always an awkward thing when you recognize the wrong person.
Dude, one time I thought I saw my buddy, like, walking, like, it was like we're in a mall. And I thought it was him, and I was like, yo, Mark. And I started running at him, and the dude turned around, and it wasn't him. I just kept running past him. I was like, Mark. Like, really? Like, it was a dude further down the way. I was like, oh, shit, that's not even going.
You just forced like, somebody further down. Out of the mall?
I just kept going.
That was smooth, man.
Right out of the mall.
That was smooth.
Dude, I thought it was that guy.
That was smooth.
Like, Mark, what's up, Mark? And oh, you could man. Tell, like, the guy was like, I think this person's going to like, and they turn around, and was like, Mark,
then he felt bad. Like, he was like, oh man, it's not even about
he's
me.
Like, hey, it's not okay. It wasn't me. Yeah. Like, no, I wasn't talking to you at all.
His wife was like, he always thinks somebody's calling him.
His name's not even Mark. It's Steve. It's not even sound like.
Why are you always turning around?
Yeah. Ralphie was on here.
On what?
On this shirt.
Oh, for it?
Yeah.
Yeah,
my God.
The comedy lineup was
Mark Norman's the last name on there.
Wow.
Yeah, Nick Thune, Funches.
I was just with Nick Thune. I am blanking right here. It'll come to me in a minute. We were opening for Nate Bargatze in South Carolina early this summer. Nick Thune is hilarious.
Yeah.
Whoa.
It's weird because he's so quiet.
Very
I met him on
quiet.
The bus when we were doing that taping.
Oh, yeah.
And he was just super, I don't know, he might have been tired as hell, too.
Like, no, that's Nick.
Yeah.
Yeah, man, he's like super chill. Like, yeah.
Oh, man. Yeah. I would be like, that guy hates me.
No, he's a good dude, but he's just real chill. Like, it just, like everybody, now I think about it, everybody on that show was like low energy, like real chill.
Yeah, I was about to say, you're pretty chill.
It's getting real chill right now.
Speaking of your album.
Oh!
Nice.
Got you some Southern Comfort.
Oh, man, thank you.
The good
thank
stuff.
Y'all, man. Appreciate you, man.
So I saw that Godfrey had started calling you that?
Godfrey,
that?
Did, he did start calling me that. He said when we worked together the first time in Virginia, he was talking about my style, like, because I'm not your normal. Like, I don't really show any emotion. I don't move. Like, it's, it's like real, like almost boring. But it hits. So, you know, when it hits, because there's been times where it doesn't hit, and it when it doesn't hit, ooh shit, like this shit, it hurts. Bombing with low energy hurts a different way.
You don't show emotion, but you feel
right.
it.
Like know. if you bomb, you got high energy and you bomb, it's like, oh well. It's almost kind of like music. If you ever see, you go to a concert and you ever go to those concerts where nobody really cares about the opening act, everybody's talking, but you can't, like, it doesn't bother them because all they hear is the music. So if you like high energy, you just jumping all over the place. You don't care.
No.
You're not high energy, though.
I'm not, but if when you watch people bomb with high energy, it's the most uncomfortable thing.
No, I'm talking about for them. They're okay. You don't think they're okay?
Just, you can tell they're just not happy. But
nobody's happy about bombing.
You know, well, I mean, you know, yeah, like, they're too over the top. You're like, you got to address it. You can't keep that same energy. You got to break your character for a second.
I appreciate it, dude.
You got to acknowledge the bomb.
I appreciate it because it's some people.
You can't high kick your way out of this.
Well, sometimes they do, though. Like, some people, if they stick with it, like, they'll end up beating the crowd into submission, and they'll get on board. I like those that will do that. I can't do it, but I respect them. You don't think so?
I don't know.
It's like, I disagree.
It's like, it's to me, like, high energy is almost like watching bad improv.
Ooh.
You know, like, it's good improv is extremely funny. Like, it's very good. But bad improv, like, when you can't break the fourth wall.
Oh, yeah.
Like,
just
address it. Address that it's not going well. Please.
Oh, this is awesome, man. This is so awesome. Appreciate this.
That bad improv's the worst thing in the world.
Mm. Yeah.
It's the most awkward cringe. I just think of Michael Scott. Every time I'm watching it, I think of Michael Scott.
Yeah.
Taking the scene over every time. Oh, I love it.
Like shooting everybody.
They're like tagging themselves in. You're like, oh, no, this guy again.
I got an idea. Same thing. He's just committed. I freaking love it.
Oh, man.
Well, speaking of music, next thing I got you.
Whoa.
Oh, man.
You a fan?
I am. I am a huge fan now.
People
I used
give
to
you
make
shit
fun
for that?
Of them. They used to. Nobody says shit now.
What?
Amazing. I just want to show this. If Zach Townsend sees this, checkmate right there.
Wait. Hello. Yeah. Wait, what's the deal? Why won't people talk shit about them now? Because everybody seems to hate them.
They used
them.
To.
People are accepting them with arms wide open currently.
Yeah.
Why?
So, I used to shit on them too.
Yeah.
Big time. So much so that I, it was a couple years ago, I think like 2016, I made a fake Facebook event on that... Like, I made a fake Facebook event that Creed was coming to the parking lot in Kmart in Smyrna, Tennessee.
What?
Oh, where's my phone? And I called it the Arms Still Wide Open Tour. And I created it like 6 months before the event was.
Yeah.
And completely forgot about it. Like, I thought it would get like some laughs. Nobody liked it or anything.
Yeah.
And 6 months go by, and then the day of the event, like, I start getting all these notifications on Facebook. Hang on.
Do people show up?
Yes.
What?
Yeah. Creed Arms Still Wide Open Tour.
Yo.
Yeah.
The photo you used to.
How many people responded?
Oh, I mean, let me go to the discussion. I love this memory lane. I mean, first of all, it says the description should have known it was fake.
Yeah.
It says they're back and better than never.
Someone else, like, I'm going.
Dude, it says clock out and come catch the amazing Creed perform all their greatest hits during your lunch break on Monday, June 27th.
Says, on your lunch break?
Yeah, because I put the hours of like 12:37 to 1:32 p.m.
Somebody showed up at 12:37.
Dude, and then it says free admission with proof of purchase. And so, God, let me find this.
Free admission, a proof of purchase, proof of a ticket? Hell no.
And I mean,
dude, that's so stupid.
I forgot all about it. And these people's, I can't work. There's so many comments. Man.
This feels like in the other guys when he's like, you learn ballet ironically just to make fun of kids.
Yeah, dude. Stuff's gay, man. I would never.
You made a Creed event just to make fun of
kids. Oh, my God.
And now I love
and to
Creed.
Ruin their
because
day.
Of that? You love them because of that?
No, I think just getting older. I'm just like, you know what?
Took a while to understand
they're
Creed's
not that
music.
Bad.
I gotta be honest.
Paved in gold sound nice nowadays.
Yeah. Yo, he was thinking about some real life shit back then, and nobody was giving him the credit. Have you ever heard the story about T.I.?
But
saving him from jumping off a balcony in a hotel.
Who?
Oh, Scott Staff. Yeah, he became an Alabama fan after that or something crazy.
Yeah. Wait.
Yeah, tell the story.
Yeah.
Scott is actually he. I think he has it somewhere. But
wait, he started doing stand up after that, dude.
Yeah.
Who? T.I.?
No, Scott Staff. Well, I think T.I. did too.
Yeah. Now Scott Easton, I think, has a story about this. That's who I heard it from. Is
about Scott Staff.
Scott Staff getting saved by
from Scott Easton. There's a lot of Scott.
Scott, yeah. Scott Staff getting saved by T.I. at a hotel.
Yes,
when he's about to like jump off a balcony or something. Mm.
You can do whatever you like.
Now, have y'all seen T.I. do? Have y'all seen him stand up?
No, I've heard it's been atrocious though.
I saw a video of him like chewing out a comedian.
Turns out he can do whatever he likes. I just had to throw it. He might be good. I don't know. I just had to throw it in there.
We did a show with him. On accident in Atlanta. He showed up to the show and was like, it was Godfrey was headlining. And after Godfrey got off stage, like T.I., they were like, yo, you wanna go up? And T.I. went up there and did 40 minutes after Godfrey did an hour and a half.
What?
An hour 40. Yeah.
Oh, I remember that story.
Yeah. Yeah, that was crazy. It was a. It's a weird night.
Yeah.
And did it change the way you listen to his music?
No, I kept it separate. Thank God, because I love his music. But, man, you know, I got to be honest, though. When I saw him there, it was rough. I think I might have watched a minute. But repetition, you get better. And then when I saw him in Nashville, like a couple months later, he was a lot better. So, I'm assuming he's probably a lot better now, I would hope.
Yeah, somebody was saying, like, the people that he has open for him are all killers.
Killers, like, yeah. Jay Ski, shout out to Jay Ski, K-Dub, my dude in Atlanta, and, Ronnie Jordan. Yeah, he got some killers. They are stage killers.
It's pretty awesome.
Yeah.
Respect. I mean, anybody that keeps at it, because, you know, I think I saw a video where he's getting, like, booed. I mean, like an arena.
Yeah, that was in, in Brooklyn.
Yeah, so to take that and keep going.
To me, music is just so much cooler than comedy. Yeah. If I could be a badass musician, it just feels like even when it's bad, you can still trick people into like...
Yeah, like if I was him good. And I was bombing, I would just start rapping.
Breaking my song.
Exactly. Yeah.
Yo, hit my track.
Let's play the hits.
Dun, 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 dun. Yeah.
Just play it. I mean, but you know, like it's an easier transition for somebody like him because... You already got the stage presence. That's a big part of it. If you already got the performance.
He knows how to write hooks.
Yeah. Like nobody's business.
Yeah.
So, yeah, I mean.
It's a rubber band man.
It makes sense.
Dude, he's got money, hoes, cars, and clothes.
Rubber band man.
Wild as the Taliban. He was right there.
I think it was a 9 in his right and a 45 in the other hand.
Yeah. I mean, that's shooting. That's going to be way off.
Yeah, man. That's
you're going to be very inaccurate.
I don't know why you would mismatch them, though. Like, I would either get a 45, two 45s.
I mean, one's
or two
barely
nines.
Got kick and the other one's just.
Right. Just firing off.
Oh, the 9 was in his right. So he's shooting.
9 in his right.
Heavier.
Yeah, because it was
45. Is he left handed? Mm-hmm. That makes me wonder because that's going to have
conspiracy
way
conspiracy theory.
What a 9 is. The 9 is straighter. That's more accurate.
It is, but you're going to want more accuracy.
In your offhand.
Yeah, because he's going to have way more kick on that 45 if he's not.
That's a good point. Left-handed. But do you really have time if you're pulling it out to figure out which gun is which? Like, oh, this the 45 has got to go on my left hand. Or would you just, probably start shooting? You thinking about this?
You're like, okay, hang on, actually.
Yeah, like, you know what? I got this all mixed up.
All right. No, I'm dead. All right.
Okay, you go.
Oh, he got me. I should have shot that 45.
I don't know why, with the whole time in my head, I was picturing you playing paintball in this scenario.
No, this is life or death.
Yeah. Like, oh, he got me. I'm bleeding.
Mike, next thing I got you. I figured you could identify this.
Oh, okay. Okay. Appreciate you. Yo, tell me you get it.
Yeah, from Space Jam.
I mean, it's only the greatest Space Jam. This is the real Space Jam.
Yeah, finished? Great speech and all, Doc. You had them riveted. But didn't you forget something?
What?
Your secret stuff.
Appreciate that, man. This is dope, man. Because this is the real stuff. This is
the secret stuff.
This is how Daffy Duck got his powers. Mm-hmm. This is why he was killing. Daffy needed this, and Mike knew it. He knows how to bring the best out of you, man. Yeah. Where did you even find this at?
Same thing, the internet, man.
Yeah, the internet's a weird place.
This is awesome. Thank you, man.
You're wearing the Scottie Pippen slippers, too.
Yeah, you know what?
Scottie probably drank some of that.
I'm a little mad at Scottie right now. I don't know.
He's not been doing great. Huh?
He seems a little hurt.
Well, I mean, well, Jordan, to be fair. Yeah. To
banging
be,
his wife.
I would have a little problem with that myself. Dude, that but Jordan didn't. Tough. He don't like it. He said it. He said he don't approve of that relationship. But, you know, I still would have something to say.
Dude, that would be tough.
If your son is beating my ex-wife.
Yeah, dude, that would.
It's the final layup.
If it was Mike, you'd be like, okay, I get it.
Yeah.
Michael Jordan.
Yeah.
But the offspring? Oh, man. Like, your son? You understand how disrespectful that is?
Yeah.
Your best teammate. The greatest player ever. I'm gonna get his son. I don't like what you're saying, Scotty.
His family stole everything from me.
Everything.
Number two again.
I was so underpaid because of all the money he was talking. My contract could have been so much bigger.
Dude, do you get this? Like, psychologically, how, dude, that is damaging. Like, this whole time, I've been number two.
I couldn't even see him again. I'm just like, Michael. Like, yeah. You couldn't look him in the eyes.
I've been number two my whole career. And then I retire, and my son, my ex-wife, is messing with Michael Jordan's.
Turns out he's number three.
You go to the back of the bus, dog.
Yeah, you should have had that secret sauce.
So we're talking about T.I.
Uh-oh.
But what about old DMX?
Yo, come on, man. Come on, dude.
I'm trying to find the vinyl of it.
Yo, what is this?
CDs still work.
Dude, this is the greatest album ever. I listen to this till my ears bleed. Like, you have no idea, dude. This.
Would you put it up against Creed?
I would, dude.
We can do it right now.
I would love to. I would. What's your top song on there? Cause I already know what mine is. It's a tough.
I mean,
take some time.
God, it's Arms Wide Open or Higher. It's got Higher.
That's
it's
what you got
to be Higher.
Is that what you go with? Higher.
Yeah.
Cause I'm gonna go with the Rough Rider Anthem, and that shuts everything down.
Yeah. Pretty good.
That shuts
everything.
It opens up.
Shut shit down, open up shop.
Oh.
Creed ain't doing that. Creed ain't shutting shit down.
I'm not going to disrespect Creed like that. They've had enough.
What's the other group everybody hates?
Nickelback.
Nickelback, that's it. I like a couple of their songs.
They were just in Nashville.
When?
Like 2 weekends
ago. Were they at Kmart?
No, they weren't at.
Why you didn't make one?
Oh, I forgot. Meal?
You made a post for them?
No.
Oh, I was about to say, holy shit, dude.
You're, that event started like 2 weeks. You're going to be so pissed.
The funniest
I might have been there.
Yeah, it says it right there. Kmart parking lot, Smyrna, Tennessee. But in the discussion, these people were like, I'm here right now.
Yo, is that the voice you imagine them doing?
And her name's Charlene. So it's Charlotte. That's got to be her voice.
Oh, that's funny.
Oh, there's Charlene right here. Just talk to someone at Kmart, and this is a sick joke. That was not too funny, as I'm a huge fan of Creed. And then,
yo,
I said, I don't think Kmart is affiliated with the event. Big mistake, bookings are the ones who put it on. And then people were like, what are you talking about? I'm here right now. And they were posting pictures of like Google images of Scott. And the thing is, then somebody else came in and found the same, a Google image from the same show. So it looked like it was the same thing.
Oh.
So they just destroyed some lives.
Michael.
And then people are like, I'm here right now. I can taste his sweat. And I'm just like at my 9-to-5 job, just in the office, just dying laughing.
Why is my phone going off like this?
It just kept going off. I was like, what is going on?
Somebody thought you were going viral.
Yeah.
Thought you was going super viral.
That was not my first thought. I was like, oh,
yeah, the hopes and dreams of 400 Creed fans.
Dude, oh, man. What if you caused a riot? That would have been hilarious.
I just know because the lady.
A riot? Of course that would happen in Kmart's parking lot. That would be the perfect place for that to happen.
There's a lady on here that, like, I just went inside and asked one of them. They said they don't know anything about it.
Dude.
Like, you know that person? I was like, what?
Yeah, you know how.
The hell are you talking about, lady?
Who's Creed?
Where's the stage at?
Is Creed like at the Kmart
nothing,
parking lot?
When you pulled up, nothing was like, this is kind of weird. You didn't see any microphones.
Yes.
No amps, nothing.
Yeah, they just skipped right over Nashville. They weren't going as far as Murfreesboro. They're going to go right to Smyrna.
Right.
Smyrna Kmart parking lot.
Kmart parking lot.
Someone sent a text message to someone that day going, someone just asked me if Creed was performing here.
I just think of, like, yeah, all the scenarios that played out.
Like, what if she,
lives.
Like, I imagine her, like, calling her friends and stuff. Hey, you going to the Creed concert? Where's it at? It's in a Kmart parking lot. Like, oh, I probably won't go to that.
It's the sickest venue.
They're really in touch with their fans.
Who books that?
Right.
Big mistake bookings.
Mistake book. Did you have a name?
Yeah, I said it was.
You
big
had a promoter
bookings.
Name? Oh, my God. You had a name for the promoter. Dude, you thought through everything.
There was one.
How much were the tickets?
There wasn't a, it was a free concert.
Oh, that's right. You did say.
Yeah. I said free admission.
Free admission with the proof of purchase. Dude.
So, like, everything about it was just.
And nobody got their head twisted up with that. Oh, that's crazy.
So you got Love Creed fans.
There used to be a comment, I guess it got deleted.
Yeah, what does that say about their,
like,
fans?
Some guy was just like, fuck you. I'm like, that's someone.
Somebody said that to you?
Yeah, just straight up, it just said, fuck you.
He did that in the parking lot.
I was like, oh,
He didn't go home and do that. He did that in the parking lot. He was like,
and then there was somebody, I was like, oh, I knew this was a joke. And I was like, then why did you show up to Kmart? They just started running.
Jokes on you, I was going to Kmart anyway. Who goes to Kmart on purpose?
Not me. I go to Food Lion.
Food Lion?
Yeah, that's a deep cut. There's not many of those. I think Smyrna might have the only. Now I live in Smyrna. I didn't live there at the time. We used to always make fun of the city.
My dad lives in Smyrna.
It was like north of Murfreesboro, and we always made fun of everybody. And I was like, I never live in Smyrna, and now I live in Smyrna.
That's funny.
Now you got to deal with all the local pissed off Creed fans.
Yeah. They see me all the time. They're like, I don't forget you.
Dude, this is so awesome, though. Man, I really appreciate it. Wow. DMX. It's crazy because my wife, during the pandemic, 2020, this is May during the pandemic, in the middle of it. So me and my wife, we had to switch back and forth, who would go to the grocery store. Like, because we didn't want to take the kids out. Cause it was cold.
Drawing straws.
Yeah, so we was like, so we would just like go back and forth. So this time, it was my go, but she was like, I don't trust what you're gonna get. So she was like, I'll go. I was like, cool. So she goes to the Bellmead Kroger.
Mm-hmm.
She goes there and then she calls me, and she's like, hey, I just saw your boy. So she said, I'm thinking of my friend. She was like, I was like, who? She was like, your favorite rapper. Now I'm thinking it's somebody that I know. So it's a guy that I went to school with that's a rapper. We played on the same team. It's
Jelly Roll.
So I was like, you talking about paper? She was like, nah. She was like, and this is what really pissed me off. She said, what's the guy that barks? I said, DMX? She was like, yeah, he's here. He's here. We were picking strawberries in the produce together. DMX is, and she's like, he was in there with no mask on, just taking pictures with everybody. And then, like, what, 5 months later, he dies? I'm like, ugh.
Yeah.
No, it was like 7 months later when he died. So So I never get that opportunity to meet him.
You'll never be able to pick strawberries.
Never be able to pick strawberries, dude.
You'll never be able to pick strawberries.
You understand? I would have flipped out picking strawberries with DMX.
That'd be the greatest Instagram ever.
I'm like holding up strawberries, like
with a little bucket of them.
Yeah. But you and then
he's just slapping cantaloupes in the produce.
You can't have a strawberry and not smile. So. But you can't take a picture with DMX and smile. So it's like it's very confusing. Like you gotta really nail that picture, cause X don't. I can't see him smiling in no picture.
He's just
X gonna get some strawberries.
X gonna give it to
you. Hey, can you hand me those strawberries?
X gonna give it to you. Thank you, DMX. Oh.
What y'all really want? Here's some strawberries.
Just some strawberries, DMX.
Oh, man. Oh, you know that rapper that barks? Like, no, that was just that kid in high school.
Oh, my gosh, dude. And she knows that's my favorite rapper.
One of the last things we got for you. Live, Laugh, Love is funny.
That.
But.
Is amazing.
Love and Affection's better.
Dude, Love and Affection gives me an erection.
No, that's funny.
That being said, ladies, I am single. Yeah. And DTF. Oh, down to fall in love. Long-term commitment. That's my fetish. That's what I'm into. Yeah. Some people like feet or getting shit on, but not this guy. No. Love and affection gives me an erection. That's what I like to say. Yeah. Yeah. Honesty and trust makes me bust. That's gross.
Oh, I'm going to put this up in my bathroom. That means so much.
Put
Thank
it on
you
your
guys.
Front door.
Y'all are like, y'all have a gift at gifts.
Yeah, man. Y'all are really
it's
thoughtful.
It's just people that care.
Yeah.
Thank and that you. Means so
or
much.
Or we're just like creepy.
Yeah. It's borderline. But it's awesome though, man. I really appreciate it.
I wasn't thinking about that.
Yeah. Until now.
Until now. Yeah.
He's like, wait till
give you a sign about an erection.
Yeah. Wait till you find the clones we have. Yeah.
Now that I think of it in that context, the sign's kind of
so
fucked up.
So you had a post about a dead cousin. Guess who I found?
Yeah. You never our next guest.
Yeah.
Had to do a little digging, but we got him.
We got you a vial of our blood.
That really is digging deep.
Had to dig for him, but we got him.
We tried to find you a Jathan thing, but they don't make any.
Oh, like a keychain?
Hi, my name is
Oh, that would've been awesome.
It was so frustrating. Like, even like, it would just be like, you mean Nathan? And be like, no, I don't.
Jason? Dude.
That's so funny.
The funny thing about that joke was like the amount of Jathans that came out of the woodwork.
There are Jathans?
There's a ton of them.
Oh, wow. What'd they say?
They were all just like, finally, my name gets some recognition or fuck you. It was like no in between.
Still pissed about the Creed.
Yeah.
Yeah, the overlapping Jathan that went to the Creed concert.
Dude.
Like,
He's like, I hate this guy.
Dude. Somebody.
What have I done to Matt Taylor?
He's
what do I do?
Life.
What did I do to deserve this, man?
My wife left me.
First Creed, now Jathan.
Because I skipped our counseling session and go to Creed concert. And then Scott Stapp, I don't even think he was there.
I told you it wouldn't be at Kmart. He didn't.
Oh.
They're coming.
I'll bet our marriage.
I'll bet our. If they don't show, we can divorce.
You can have the house.
So,
I'll give it to you.
The parking lot's huge. It's put in a room for them. Nobody's ever there.
Yo, oh my gosh, dude. That is hilarious. A terrible prank, but so funny.
Is it though? I mean, I'm waiting for the day that I get to meet Scott.
It's a victimless prank.
Yeah, it's really not even a prank because you didn't think anybody would take it serious.
No, I saw people doing like fake events on Facebook, and what I found out later is they create these fake events, then change it to their event.
Oh,
that's smart.
Yeah.
So then these people are like scammed into being like, seeing the event. And I was like, oh, I just made a fake event. Yeah. Like I was for fun,
and then forgot about it. That's the most
totally
important part.
Forgot about it. It's like I don't even know. It must have been 6 months.
Dude, that's so funny.
All right, well then, last thing, segue into the movie.
Oh man, this is awesome.
Oh, nice.
Wayne's World.
Hell yeah.
Yeah.
What made you pick Wayne's World?
So Wayne's World is probably the most memorable movie to me in like my childhood. Probably the most watched movie too. I would say it's easily the movie I've seen the most in my life.
Like, was it just one of those VHSs that you just...
Yeah, like, it's just so much behind it, just nostalgic-wise. We'd watch it every time we went to our grandparents' house. If we went on road trips with them, they had, like, this... Somehow they hooked the TV up into their van, and we would watch it on the way.
All right, wrap it up.
Is that Creed?
I don't even know what this is.
With a whole world under sunlight.
That's how Chad Kroger sounds. He sounds exactly.
He does, yeah.
I thought that's what
they should go on tour together. Would blow everything out of the water.
I go to that.
But the movie means a lot to me. Like, it's a lot of memory, a lot of fun, childish laughs, and
those movies
like even
at
this.
Your grandparents' house just hit different.
Yeah. It was
you
that.
Had to watch them every
Ninja
time.
Ninja Turtles.
There.
Nothing else to do.
Yeah.
Yeah. So let's just go watch
They never
this.
Had the right cable package. It was oh, always no. just like, oh my God.
It was always yeah. super basic.
Which Ninja Turtles?
The first one.
Okay.
The very
oh,
first
yeah.
one.
Yeah.
The good like one.
That. The dark one.
Was it yeah. dark?
Compared to what followed, yeah.
Yeah, yeah.
Oh, I mean, yeah, it was dark.
I guess it was.
They cursed in that
I remember
one.
Raphael
yeah.
cursed.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
I was
Damn.
Like, what?
Yeah.
I couldn't believe that.
Leonardo yeah. would never.
Come back here! I'm not finished with you! Damn!
How y'all feel about the new... Have y'all...
I haven't
y'all got any thoughts about going to see it? Y'all gonna see it?
I might go now that I got a nephew.
You
not
use him?
Recently. He's three, so he's been around for a minute now. But
he's three?
Yeah.
Cool. Holding the baby.
Like, we took him
That's
to see Donatello.
Super Mario. Oh, that was dope. Yeah. Super Mario was
It was
dope.
Great, but yeah.
It was good.
Like,
oh. Yeah, it was. They finally got that right, because that
they
first one
it.
Was horrible.
Oh, man, with John Luke
was
awful.
Oh,
so
gosh,
yeah.
that was horrible,
it
dude.
It was awful. Well, they didn't have CGI, really.
I mean, but even the storyline was terrible.
It was
like,
bad.
Ugh.
What's crazy, so we're talking about grandparents' movies. Our movie that was out at our grandparents' house was Hook.
Mm.
And Bob Hoskins plays Mario,
oh,
and he's
okay.
Smee and
yes.
Hook.
And he was in Roger Rabbit, too.
Oh, yeah, he was.
Yeah.
Didn't he read, didn't you say he was, like, seeing a rabbit? Like, he went so
oh,
crazy.
Oh, yeah,
because
he
oh, really?
He had to visualize it while acting, and then he just, like, kept seeing it afterwards.
Wow. Mm-hmm. That's crazy. I didn't know that.
It's called schizophrenia.
I mean, it does kind of, like, actors are weird people in general.
Yeah.
But to be, like, I don't know, to see a rabbit, that would mess me up to see a cartoon rabbit, especially if it didn't look alike. Like, if it didn't look like Roger Rabbit,
yeah.
I think that would mess me up even more, because I'd be like, it's not even, it's Kmart. It's Kmart version Roger
so
Rabbit.
Why didn't see
what it? If you kept seeing the redheaded?
That's what I was going to say. Why not Jessica? Why?
That would
yeah.
be nice. You're like, hey,
I
yo,
would,
I love
complain about that.
This
well,
is
speaking of rabbits, Wayne's World, the line...
Oh, yeah,
when
yeah.
Bugs Bunny dresses like a lady rabbit, do you
yeah.
think
Oh,
she's
yeah,
that
was funny. That's the part I laughed at.
You know that was, yeah.
Yeah. Oh, I could
yeah,
tell.
Yeah, so his laugh, he's like,
yeah.
What?
I could tell that yeah. was, yeah. I was like, he made that, Dana Carver had to make that up.
Did you ever find Bugs Bunny attractive when he'd put on a dress and play a girl bunny?
No. No.
Neither did I. I was just asking.
Me and my brother, the part that's coming up, used to rewind and watch probably 10 times every time.
Yeah,
it's just the hi, Wayne. Hi. And she hits the car.
Yeah, yeah, on the bike.
Flips over. We just pause it, rewind it, just watch her flip.
You know, he almost
She's
cut
okay.
that out of the movie.
Really?
He was like very like, I don't know if this is, you know, it feels too kind of slapsticky. And he said it was ended up being one of their bigger laughs, and he was like, I'm glad I kept that.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, the opening scene, Bohemian Rhapsody, he had to fight for them to take that song.
Really?
Car. That hits me so hard.
Car.
Yeah, when
Game
they're like
on.
Having to stop what you're doing
oh, yeah.
in the street and mm-hmm. like let the car go by.
There's some kids yeah. that have to do that every time I drive past them. Like, seriously, in my neighborhood, they have a little field hockey thing, a little goal set up, and they'll have to stop. And I enjoy it every time.
You're just thinking car.
Yeah.
Dude, I'm going to be honest with you. This is my first time watching this movie. I had never seen it before.
What'd you think?
Thought it was hard. Hard to watch.
I thought it'd be hard. Like
Wayne goes hard.
Yeah, it goes hard.
No, I ain't gonna lie. I struggle watching this one. Because I kept doing it. I kept falling asleep, and then I would wake up and have to rewind and go back. That whole little thing.
And she's already wearing neck braids.
Yeah. And then she rolled over.
Then she pops up. She's like, eh.
That's a young Laura Flynn Boyle. Ain't a Laura Flynn Boyle?
Yeah.
That's a young.
I was trying to think of that earlier. I was like, who is that actress?
Yeah, you remember. She was in, what was that show? The Practice. I remember her from that.
And funny Rob story Lowe. About Rob Lowe, his career was dead.
This to this?
The movie that revamped it.
Really?
Because he had had like a porn leak, like him and a lady.
Two 16-year-old girls.
Yeah, it kind of like ruined his career. Really? And nobody wanted to work with him, gave him a chance on this movie.
He's R. Kelly?
Yeah.
Rob Riggle, I don't know if he peed on him. Riggle was like, Rob Lowe, sex tape with two girls. He can't even carry a sex tape.
I think the main person in this movie, though, is Garth. Like, if you go back and watch it, like, he's so much better in all the scenes.
Are you more Dana Carvey over Mike Myers? Yes. Is that your...
I used to not be until I got
What
older.
Made that switch, or why do you like Dana Carvey?
I've just heard some stories. So I think you start to think negatively about somebody. But I'm not gonna blast Mike Myers. He's given us timeless treasures like Wayne's World, Austin Powers.
Love Guru.
I love Guru. That was the best, if you ask me. Yeah. Dude, my brother's wife's dad used to be roommates with a girl that dated him, Mike Myers.
No way.
And he didn't really know who he was. He said they were roommates, and he woke up one night and was like in the kitchen going to get like some water. And Mike Myers was in there just like shuffling around cute like note cards. And he's like, what are you doing? He's like, I'm just trying to rearrange order and stuff for this movie idea that I have. And it was Wayne's World.
No way.
Oh, that's crazy. Yeah. Tia Carrera.
Excellent.
Cool. I forgot she was in
it. Oh, yeah. I mean, she's.
I used to be in love with her.
Oh, man.
She's a babe.
Remember Crucial her? Taunt.
Was that
babe.
High school? High?
Oh, yeah.
Oh, fun fact coming up. That's actually Dana Carvey playing the drums.
Really?
Yeah. Wait, no way.
He's a phenomenal drummer.
He slays.
The way I figured this out, or I even looked it up, I was watching whenever Aerosmith was on Wayne's World on SNL as like the guest. And I was like, they are doing the Wayne's World song at the end. And you see Garth in the back, or Dana in the back playing the drums. I'm like, and you hear the drums and like, it looks exactly like what he's playing. And it was good.
It did.
So then like I look it up and sure enough, he's like an amazing drummer. So this is, they did first take. They didn't have to redo anything.
Now that makes the scene even better when the guy walks up like, you're really good.
And he goes, thanks. I like to play.
I like to play.
And whenever they play Stairway to Heaven, they can only play three chords, because if you played four, everybody's getting like lawsuits from Zeppelin for playing Stairway to Heaven.
Mm-hmm. I love that.
Very specific.
No Stairway.
So that he plays like the first, not chords, the first three notes.
Yeah. I don't,
and then you
I
can't
think
play
they
it
dubbed
anymore
it
else.
Over.
Did they?
In the theaters, I heard someone bragging, like, I saw it before they changed the notes.
Oh, and he played too much?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, wow.
Whoa, that's cool.
No Stairway. Denied.
I feel like this movie is just so 90s.
Yeah, it's very
early 90s.
You know? Yeah, like, yeah. Right from 90 to 95.
Yeah.
Ed O'Neill, the guy that works at the
like restaurant, he makes me feel so like time has passed so much. Like with him. He's so believable as that, like,
yeah.
I can't believe I'm doing this. I can't believe I'm working here.
That's the youngest I've ever seen him, and he looks 45.
Yeah. I think he's 46, actually.
Wow. He is the only other character in this movie that talks to the camera.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Like,
yeah.
That's a great
only
scene.
Only we do that.
Yeah. He's like, uh-uh. This is a great scene right here.
Oh, yeah, the product
placement. Sellout scene.
Yeah, who would want to do that?
This felt the most like Austin Powers to me.
Damn. Yes.
Look how old those Doritos are.
He's definitely got a style. Yeah, the old bag. Yeah. I love when they go over to Garth. He's just decked out in the Reebok.
I thought about wearing that if I...
That's awesome. That would have been so awesome.
It would have been.
Listen, we need to have a talk about Vanderhoff. The fact is, he's the sponsor. And you signed a contract guaranteeing him certain concessions, one of them being a spot on the show. Well, that's where I see things just a little differently. Contract or no, I will not bow to any sponsor. I'm sorry you feel that way, but basically it's the nature of the beast. Maybe I'm wrong on this one, but for me, the beast doesn't include selling out.
Garth, you know what I'm talking about, right?
It's like people only do things because they get paid. And that's just really sad.
I can't talk about it anymore. It's giving me a headache.
Here, take two of these.
Ah, Nuprin. Little. Yellow. Different.
Look, you can stay here in the big leagues and play by the rules, or you can go back to the farm club in Aurora. It's your choice.
Yes. And it's the choice of a new generation.
So, Mike, did you finish the movie?
I did not.
When did you tap out?
Man, I don't even remember. it was right after, Mike Myers, Wayne, after he apologized.
Wayne.
It's like he showed up at your house and was like, oh, God, this fucking
works. Yeah, Wayne. No, Wayne. Yeah. He's at it again.
And with the hello, Newman.
Hello, Newman.
So right after he apologized, that's when I...
Oh, and there is no film in this camera?
Oh, God. That maybe, bit cracked me up.
That's pretty much the end.
Maybe before that. No. I can't remember. It was like when he realized he was wrong. I think that's where I was at.
I thought the first ending was the best, with the girl on the beach with Rob Lowe.
Yeah.
So I was like, this is totally how this story actually ends.
So it's two parts of this? It's another movie? It's a sequel?
No, there is another one.
Why? Why would they do that?
They got a huge budget for it, and they didn't even have the original director.
It bombed.
The first one. Yeah, it didn't do well. I mean, it did okay, but not near as good as... This is completely improv'd. Jimi Hendrix.
How does he do it?
I'm coming to get you. I mean, look at that. Those moves? Come on. With the Motley Crue shirt?
I just always picture him like, that was so sad. He's had all these legendary roles, and I just picture him as turtle guy.
No, not turtle enough for the turtle club?
Master disguise.
Yeah. That's like, oh, I can see him.
I almost wonder if it's funnier to watch this without sound.
Yeah, I know, right? Because I'm looking. I'm like, this is actually pretty good.
I've come
circle around.
It's like Creed a little bit. Like, it takes a while.
It's a good silent movie, man.
Wait, you mean like Creed in the sense that if you listen to it without sound, it's better?
You just watch the music video. You watch it without sound, it's a little homoerotic. He never has a shirt. But he's ripped, so.
Yeah, this is funny on mute.
Yeah, people say that about people say that about my comedy, too. This guy's hilarious on mute.
Just on mute. Hilarious.
They send it right back. Hey, we didn't have any sound on that. Like, it works better like this.
Yeah, look at the facial expressions.
I mean, pretty good.
One time, when I first started comedy, I set up the skull, and I was so pumped about it. I was just like, "Yeah, dude, they filmed it. I'm the best." I was like bugging him about sending it to me. Like, oh, hey, no. Can you send me that?
Oh, no.
And I got it, and I just had to be like, oh, you must have sent me someone else's. This definitely wasn't mine. But don't worry about it. I'll be back. Yeah, I'll see you later.
Like, no, we watched that one.
Deleted the email address I sent it from.
Oh, that's hilarious.
I had to get a whole new email.
Yeah. Dude, look at this fool, man.
That is funnier without sound.
Yeah, you know what I'm saying? Because when I watched this part earlier, I was like, eh. But now this shit is actually funny.
Oh, boy.
I do think it's weird, like, her acting, like, fake laughing. That has to be really hard, right?
Yeah, I'm sure.
You don't fake laugh with Mike Myers.
Nah. I've been trying to do more sketch work. Acting is hard as shit.
It is. It is very hard.
Like, being seeming genuine in, like, the least genuine moment ever.
Dude, like, saying normal sentences feels weird sometimes.
Yeah. Because you're not caught off guard.
Yeah. Suddenly you don't know how to speak.
Yeah.
They're like, your line is just, hey, can you grab the butter? You're like, hey, can you grab the butter? Like, that wasn't a question.
You can't even say, like, thank you.
Yeah.
Like, ugh. I was talking to my daughter about that junk this morning. Like, she wants to be in the next Little Mermaid movie. Which she's like, Daddy, I don't know what connection she thinks I have.
You got
she's like, can you let me know when they're auditioning for this? She's 9, by the way. I'm like, I'll let you know, baby. You know, make some calls here. I don't want to ruin it for her.
I'll keep my ears open, I'm sure.
But I was telling her, like, because I did this play where it was a drama. And at the end of the play, I had to, like, cry, like, hard cry.
Oh.
And after every time I did that, I was exhausted, like, physically tired from doing, like, drawing up that type of emotion. It's tough.
So you can do that? You can cry on command?
Yeah, well, I mean.
Right now.
Let's see.
Yeah. Like, I haven't done that in years. But it was, like, to get into that mode, I thought about, I just had my son. I thought about the movie John Q. I don't know if y'all seen
it. Oh, yeah.
My son!
Oh, man.
I thought you were going to say you thought about telling her she wasn't going to get an audition for The Little Mermaid. Yeah.
It's just not in the cards.
It's just not going to happen.
I didn't want to tell
her. And then she was like, I'm having, because that's what she was telling me. She was like, I'm having trouble working on crying. So I should have did that. I'm like, well, I'm not really going to get you that audition. I'm like, good. Use that emotion right there. Uh-huh.
Bottle it up. All right. Camera, hit it.
Close up.
Yeah. Probably have to think of me putting my dog down.
Really?
Yeah, was that too dark? Sorry.
Yeah.
No, that's
right. Cue the sad violin right now.
Yeah. What kind of dog you got?
Or had. Mutt.
You had?
Yeah, I'm about to cry right now.
When do you have to put it down? Are you trying to make yourself cry?
I'm trying. Oh.
All right. So here's a secret too, and they do it in theater. Some do it. But vapor rub.
I heard they do that, or like menthol crystals and like a
whatever
straw.
Whatever.
Like,
and then you just put it right here. You like rub it right here on your face,
and eventually,
you'll start crying. But don't. I did that one time, and then it like I rubbed a little too high, and got it in there. So it's like
yeah. Start really crying.
You're like, wow, he is like
that's
really,
enough.
He's
like, one eye's barely stop. Open.
Did he have a stroke? So check
like
on
cut. He's having a stroke.
This next scene is just you happy, but you're still just like.
What is wrong with his eye?
This is a redemption scene, but he looks like he's in pain.
One of my favorite movies of all, my absolute favorite is Class Act, and I think that's like my style. That's kid and play.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, I've seen the House Party movies. Yeah. I've never seen
Class Act. Class Act was, House Party was rated R. So when I was young, I couldn't watch that. But Class Act was PG-13. I could watch that. So I just was watching that every day. That and Christmas Vacation. Couldn't stop watching that show. That movie.
Oh. Wow. Yeah. We got to come back for Christmas Vacation. I can quote that movie.
I know it from beginning to end. Verbatim.
Hey, same boss.
Think I watch Wayne's World, not going to watch Christmas Vacation? Damn.
Oh,
Bill Murray's brother, is that what you're talking about?
Oh, it is, isn't it?
Yeah.
What happened?
Same boss in Wayne's World is the boss in Christmas Vacation. Jelly of the Month.
It is. And in He was in Groundhog Day too.
Yep.
Yeah.
Yep.
My goal in life is to completely memorize his rant.
Who?
And when he gets Jelly of the Month Club. Instead
of his
pool
bonus.
Oh, I
do. I know by heart.
Can you do it right now?
What you talking about, Chevy Chase's part?
Yeah.
Where he was like,
like if he was right now, I'd tell him what to.
And I like to, and I with a big ribbon on his head, and I like to look him straight in the eye, and I want to tell him what a cheap, lying, no good, rotten, snake licking, dirt eating, inbred, overstuffed, ignorant, blood sucking, dog licking, brainless, dickless, hopeless, heartless, fat ass, bug eyed, worm sack of monkey shit he is. Hallelujah.
Holy shit.
Where's the Tylenol? Dude. Every day God. I watch that movie.
With a big ribbon on his head. And I want to look him straight in the eye, and I want to tell him what a cheap, lying, no-good, rotten, four-flushing, low-life, snake-licking, dirt-eating, inbred, overstuffed, ignorant, blood-sucking, dog-kissing, brainless, dickless, hopeless, heartless, fat-ass, bug-eyed, stiff-legged, spotty-lipped, worm-headed sack of monkey shit he is. Hallelujah. Holy shit. Where's the Tylenol?
That was
phenomenal. Yeah. I'm about to cry.
Way to go. That was impressive.
Appreciate it. Yeah, just remember.
You said acting was hard.
Yeah, that was fantastic. That. The firework rant in Joe Dirt.
Oh,
Husker do's, Husker don'ts.
With or without scooter stick.
Mm-mm.
So you're gonna tell me that you don't have no black cats? No Roman candles or screaming memes?
No.
Oh, come on, man. You don't got no lady fingers, fuzz buttles, snicker bombs, church burners, finger blasters, gut busters, zippity doodahs, or crap flappers?
No, I don't.
You're gonna stand there owning a fireworks stand and tell me you don't have no whistling bungholes, no spleen splitters, whisker biscuits, honky lighters, Husker do's, Husker don'ts, cherry bombs, nips of dazers, with or without the scooter stick, or one single whistling kitty chaser?
No. Because snakes and sparklers are the only ones I like.
This was always awesome to me, having a Twizzler dispenser in the car.
Oh, yeah, I like that touch.
I was like, damn, that's living.
I did think the meta parts of this movie were like some of the best things. Like even some of the movie references, like the Terminator 2.
Yeah, do you know this?
Yeah, like that part blew me away.
That was the actual guy too, wasn't it?
Yeah, it was the cop from Terminator looking for Sean Connor.
Yes, officer, is there something wrong?
Have you seen this boy?
Oh, man. This guy. It's like every scene that it cuts to, I'm like, oh, I remember this. Alice Cooper. Yep, remember this.
Mike's like, oh, yeah, I went to sleep right here.
Right. Now, it took me a minute to like, I was like, I know that guy's face.
Well, coming up is Chris Farley's first movie scene.
Oh, yeah, I remember that.
Yeah.
Ever?
He's going out to Detroit. I think so. I could be wrong, but I think this is his first appearance in a movie.
That guy sure does know a lot of information for being a security guard.
Yeah.
Is this Alice's limo?
No, it belongs to Frank Sharp, head of Sharp Records. Good friend of Alice's.
Wow. That's like way bigger than a normal sized car.
Well, it has to be. He drives everywhere. Hates to fly. He's going across the country right now to look for new acts assigned to his label. Next stop is St. Louis. Then he's going to come back through Chicago on his way to Detroit.
Thanks.
You know, for a security guard, he had an awful lot of information, don't you think?
You were talking about Joe Dirt. It's the wig in Joe Dirt's very similar to the Garth wig.
Yeah. Yes. Yeah.
And Dana and David Spade have a podcast now.
They do. No, I was just listening to it on the way down here.
They should do Joe episode. Dirt and Garth one episode. That'd be
same, it's the same hair.
Yeah.
It is.
They're like, just like they did the Spider-Man where they're just pointing at each other.
Oh, yeah. Mm-hmm.
It's like they just spiked up the front of Garth's hair, and that was Joe Dirt. That's a pretty good one.
Yeah.
There's
no Wayne's World.
I mean, it's no Wayne's World, but yeah, it's okay. Frank Sharp had a Sharp Records. Yeah. Yep.
He's walking like he's doing the pool guy routine. You seen the weight room?
Yeah, he is.
You ever worked with his brother before? Yeah. Work with him, yeah. Kevin Farley.
I worked with Kevin at Stand Up Live.
Yeah, I thought he was there.
That was, yeah.
It's kind of weird, right? A little eerie. Very, when you talk to him, it's like, oh.
Because they look so similar.
He came with, he was the feature I was hosting, and it was for Spade. And when he walked in, I was just like, dude, this is weird. Because he's just like him. And then, like, he'll do little movements.
Mm-hmm. The mannerisms and stuff. You're yeah.
Like, what are you? It was weird.
Yeah, I've seen him on an episode of Curb, and same thing. Like, yeah. He has those movements. And
yeah, that was a super nice guy.
Mm.
I meant to ask when we were talking about Christmas Vacation, but it's a little off topic, but we always ask, how did y'all find out Santa Claus wasn't real? Do y'all have a story there?
I almost got a fight in second grade with the kid that told me Santa wasn't real.
Dude, that's hilarious.
He was like, you tell your parents what you want. I was like, I tell Santa what I want too. And he was like, well, it's weird that I didn't tell Santa. I just told my parents and then Santa brought it. And I was just like, what are you saying? You know, like, I was like, say it. I want to hear you say it.
Started like taking your stuff off, taking your chains off.
Yeah.
Like, okay, what are you saying?
Like,
where are you going?
Taking my rings off, cracking my knuckles.
What'd
you say it again?
What you got to say about Santa?
He's not real. And like, that was the first time somebody like brought it up where I was like, blasphemy. This dude's lying his ass off right now. Yeah. And then, like, I guess maybe a year, maybe that year, I don't know. Jake was like, hey, you want to come to the attic with me real quick? My older brother.
Yeah.
And I was like, yeah, sure. And I go up there and it's like everything that I had asked Santa for.
That's
like, fine. Oh, he's just storing it here early. That's how he does it, you know? Like, I just didn't want to.
Smart.
I'm like, God. They say he works one day a year, but he works every day. He's breaking into these homes 365.
That's so funny.
So yeah, that was mine.
I never believed in Santa. Like, I didn't get to.
You just weren't that dumb?
No. No,
that's
my
so parents, hard.
When I was like little, my mom, she was a Jehovah's Witness. So it was like that sucked. Like, everybody in the classroom is like doing Christmas parties. I got to be off in the corner playing Domino Rally by myself. It was so weird. I couldn't like have none of the cookies or none of that. It looked so fun.
Did y'all do birthdays?
Nothing.
Damn.
No birthday. Like, I didn't even know.
It's about to turn into a different kind of podcast.
I didn't even know what, I didn't know when Christmas was.
Now, do you do Christmas with your kids now?
Yeah. Oh, yeah. Yeah. We stopped doing that a long time. They're like, yeah, we just couldn't.
I mean, financially, that's a brilliant idea.
It is. It is.
No birthdays, no Christmas.
No holidays, no Valentine's Day.
But also, I'd be like, well, Mom, if you're going to do that, I better get a car when I turn 16 or something.
But it's just like, it was just that, I don't know. It just was.
That sucks.
Yeah. But the good part is I never felt like my parents lied to me. That's how my son feels. That's what he told me. He was like, yeah, you lied to me.
So he's found out.
We told him too early, I feel like, because he was like, he got me. He was like, he pulled us to the side and everything. He's like, look, you guys can tell me. Is this real or not? He's super smart. So we were like, all right. It's like, we made it up. He was like, and as soon as he did, he's like, why would you do that? I'm like, oh, dude, this is her. Like, she said she said to do that. I was just
I didn't even want you to have a birthday.
Right. I was like, yeah.
You know how
you think I give a shit about these holidays?
You think I want somebody else
to give
me
credit to have a birthday?
For what I just dude, it really hurt him. So now he's like, he's super protective of his sister. He don't want her to know at all. So I was like, I appreciate that. Because if it's up to me, she would have known the same time he did. So I think we told him he was like seven or eight.
I guess that's right around the age where, like, I think even like the brain, I think, shifts into being like, wait.
You would
minute.
Think, but he actually has his best friend believes in Santa. Still. Or he's making his parents think that he, that's funny.
I have a friend that believes in Santa Stan. Totally not me.
It's not me, guys.
Oh, he ate the cookie. I mean, someone ate the cookie.
What if y'all started with that question and I was just like, what the fuck are y'all talking about right now? When did you find out Santa wasn't real?
Who told you he wasn't real?
I also love to think about, like, one of my friends listening to our podcast in the car with their kids.
Oh. Like,
how'd y'all find out Santa wasn't real? Damn podcast. Yeah.
Any kids listening there, it's not real, guys. I'm sorry.
That's why I always make sure and drop a couple F-bombs right at the beginning. Okay, let's just go to the next. Yeah, sorry. If
you want to set the mood, I appreciate that.
We're going to go back to Nate Land. Yeah.
Penguins.
It is funny, though. Santa really is the first conspiracy that we're, like, exposed to.
Yeah.
Yeah, I mean.
We are lying to our
kids.
It's
like, did we land on the moon? I don't know. Santa's not even real. So, you tell me.
Clearly.
Earth's obviously flat.
Right. They can make up anything.
Yeah.
That's how Santa gets around so fast.
Yeah, it's just direct flights are pretty easy.
Shortest distance between two points is a straight line. Yeah.
Did y'all know that, like, it's a certain point in Antarctica that you can't pass? I didn't know that.
Oh, yeah, you're not like, the ice allowed wall. To go to.
Like, nobody's allowed to. Yeah. What the hell is
Game
back
of Thrones
there?
Shit right there.
Hmm. What is back there?
The case for Santa.
I think the observatories.
Mm.
Is I that mean, all? Like, it observe
it's
us.
Santa's workshop. Right? I know exactly what it is. Yeah.
Right. Is that what you really want
that
to say?
Helps?
Truthfully, you want
all
to be like
people working that, all that people working that checkpoint at Point of Ears.
Yeah, I think it's pretty obvious, Mike.
I think we know who it is.
Are you talking about the North Pole right now? I don't know. Maybe candy canes?
Oh, man. Yeah.
Yeah, that's crazy. We can get into conspiracy theories all day.
Conspiracy theories about what?
I used to have one that I have one of my own. Nobody's ever said this, I don't think. But I think they put sugar in toothpaste. And this will probably get disproven immediately.
We're gonna get taken down off YouTube. Yeah.
You think they put sugar in toothpaste?
I do, and I think it gives you cavities, and that's why you have to keep buying it and going to the dentist. And... because I went to the dentist one time, and they're like, "You have cavities." They're like, here. You have to buy this toothpaste from them. And it was like super expensive. And I was like, what's the difference? They're like, it's anti-cavity toothpaste.
So in 6 months.
And I was like, what the hell is regular toothpaste?
So wait. And so the 6 months that you got your cleaning to the next time, you had no sugar.
Look, all right, hey. I didn't say it was a solid. I said from the get-go. You're already breaking it down.
He just discounted the whole 6 months of sugar eating, going to bed after eating a Jolly Rancher.
Twizzlers. Like, I had a Twizzler dude,
washing
my car.
It down, washing it down with a soda.
Hold on. Who are you, my dentist? Calm down. God dang, dude.
I did get a little.
He's like,
upset about
were you flossing twice a day, too? No. Were you? Why are you asking me this? Yeah, hey, just give me the laughing gas.
I did research to disprove that.
I mean, that didn't take long. I didn't even get to finish it.
Did you eat sugar or not?
So you didn't eat sugar? Okay. All right, well, I guess you're right
and
there.
And I asked you like a lawyer.
Yeah. Do you suit Stim really like, quick?
I just want to remind you, you're under oath. So
I will subpoena you for that answer.
Yeah. He's like, you tell me in the 6 months you didn't have any Frankenberry at all. You're full of shit. Let the record show.
My bad. I do get a little intense sometimes, man.
Hey, I was just kind of.
How do you think your kid asked like, you about
Santa? No, you know what it is. I get intense, man. My wife called me on it the other day because, like, the neighbor's daughter went to my son and told her that she's like, I don't want to play with Alicia. That's my daughter. She, you know, I don't want to play with her no more. So then she keeps showing up, and I was getting upset about this shit. I was like, why the fuck is she coming here if she doesn't like playing with our daughter? And then my wife was like, you know she's nine, right?
Please don't speak to her like that.
I was like, you're right. She is nine. I was upset for real. It's just misplaced anger, man. All those years, I didn't get to believe in Santa. That shit adds up, man.
No Santa, no birthday. Didn't get to pick strawberries with DMX.
You understand?
They missed a lot, dude.
Fucking strawberries with DMX, man.
That one comes out of nowhere.
And he's like barking and shit. Like, you imagine that? Like, you go in, because I was such a big DMX fan. I used to like.
What if you saw him buying dog food? That would be priceless.
What would you have done if he was there getting Frankenberry?
I knew it. I fucking knew it.
Oh my God.
Fucking knew it. Dude, dude, I'm not bullshitting. 12th grade. I was a senior in high school. I used to walk through the halls barking.
Like, oh, you were that student?
I was that guy. And I had the goggles. Yeah, I was that dude. I used to walk through the halls barking like DMX.
Oh, okay. I thought you meant like barking at the teachers and stuff.
No, I was barking like DMX. That's even worse, though. To just bark in the halls.
How'd it sound?
I ain't done it in years. So
yeah.
Yeah, that's.
I was wondering if it was. Yeah. That's incredible. Bump, bump. I can hear it.
I used to walk through the halls doing that, man. Oh, man. Good old days.
Yeah, I don't think I ever walked through the halls singing Creed. But...
See what I'm saying? It's a dog, man.
Oh. Singing my own prison.
I don't even know Creed's song, I'm gonna be honest. I do know that Higher song.
All right, and you don't know Arms Wide Open?
Mm-mm.
With arms wide open. Okay.
I ordered Creed Human Clay from one of those, like, you remember those CD magazines you get at school? It had all the CDs and you had to, like.
Yeah.
I ordered it, and instead a Jars of Clay CD showed up, and it was a huge mess.
Oh, wow.
Yeah. To think I was sitting there listening to a CD that wasn't Creed, being like, this is terrible. It would be so much better if it's Creed.
Jars of Clay, Puddle of Mud. They're all out there. A lot of earthy bands.
Hoobastank.
I mean, where do you even?
It had to be like a place.
What are y'all talking about?
Hoobastank's the name of a band. Hoobastank's the name of a band.
Oh, okay.
Just how do you even get to that
I didn't mean
name?
To be that black, but damn, I didn't know what y'all talking about.
Like, Hoobastank, it doesn't sound like just a white guy term. It could also be an Outkast album.
Oh, okay. Yeah, let's talk about Outkast.
Stankonia.
Dude.
Stankonia.
Was it Cadillac Music?
Oh, play a
Southern Catalytic Cadillac Music.
Mm-hmm. That was the
shit. Daddy Fat Sax. Dude, that is. I wish I would have thought of that name first.
Like a stallion on
Daddy
skates.
Fat Sax? Oh, I might start telling my kids to call me that.
Daddy Fat Sax.
Such a ballin' name, dude.
Dope.
My nickname used to be Matty Light.
Matty Light?
That's what I almost went as. I just stopped being Matty Light.
Matty Light?
Yeah.
Tragic. It was an error.
I mean, you got to be a pretty big piece of shit to be named after the worst beer in the world.
Matty Light.
Mm. I almost went by that when I started comedy.
Mm.
Oh, that was a good choice.
That was about to be my stage name. Yeah, I was like,
good job.
I just... When it was time to sign my name on the open mic, I was like,
just go with the real thing.
I can't do that.
You know what I was going to go by? I'm so ashamed of this. It's going to go by Megatron. That was going to be my name.
Megatron?
Yeah. I was going to be Comedian Megatron. Well, that would have been so horrible. I'm so glad. What? You think that would work?
I mean, you'd have a hard time getting that handle, but.
I know, right?
Yeah. I mean, Mike James probably isn't easy either.
No, it's another comedian named Mike James.
There's another comedian named Matt Taylor.
Are you serious?
Yeah, Nate's worked with him.
Oh, that's funny.
Yeah.
He just did a drive-by.
Who's better? Tell me who's better.
Yeah. If he ever sees this.
Is he a white guy
I'm
too?
I'm going to find you. Yeah. He messaged me one time. He's like, we have the same name. We're both a comedian. What are we going to do about this? I don't know if that's a Tony Edwards, but that's how I read it.
Yeah,
have you ever thought about going by Matty Light?
Yeah, he's like, why don't you go by Matty Light? He's like, what are we going to do about this? I was like,
I like how he made such a big deal out of it.
Like, what check clears do? Out. Give a shit.
And we're just going to keep on going, doing what we do.
I was like, I'm already doing it. What do you mean?
Yeah, the other Mike James is, well, it's another one too. So now it's three Mike James comedians.
Is there you and him on Dry Bar?
Yep. There's two on Dry Bar.
Yeah, I thought I saw
He just
that.
Did one. And then the one in, is one in LA because Craig Robinson had texted me and asked me, was I out there? Cause he saw my name on the list, and it was the other dude. Unfortunately,
yeah, I get tagged as that other guy a lot by like women that are like talking shit.
Oh wow!
It must so this guy shit. Like harassed me to come to a show. Don't ever work with him or anything.
That's the other man, I swear.
I'm just like, hey, I don't live in LA, and they're like, and then one lady was like, well, you need to change your name. I'm like, well, maybe he had a point.
Right.
Maybe you're kind
I
of.
I get
an
where
ass.
He was coming from.
Yeah.
So we're talking about Creed and Zach Townsend. I always reach out to like friends of comics, and I saw y'all were at the like. It looked like it was people in a wrestling ring just.
Oh, dueling. Armored MMA.
It's what?
That is Armored MMA. If you're ever around on the last Wednesday in Nashville of the month, it's at the Nashville Palace, like over by the Opry.
Okay.
Like that side of town, and it's. These people dressed up as like knights and they fight swords, like
real fight?
Axes. Yes.
People get hurt?
Probably. Let me see if I got some videos. I know I do.
Did anybody get hurt tonight, you were?
Somebody got knocked out. They took a knee to the face.
Sounds like my kind of party.
I mean, the best. Awesome. I mean, I hope they see this because that was. The best $40 I've ever spent in my life.
Oh, yeah.
And we were like right up on the cage. It's a very small event.
Yeah, I'm probably not going to go for $40.
It's worth it. The guy that puts it on is clearly more trained than everybody else. And he fights. Mm. The guy that he fought, he just whooped him up and down.
Damn.
And we're just like, God damn. I mean, he's like. At one point, the dude falls, and he does, like, a front flip on top of him.
Oh, he just went like, full. So, armor. What, you have to give up, or?
Well, that dude got kneed in the face and then knocked out by that same guy.
He woke up in a hospital in a full suit armor.
Oh, yeah.
Not again.
Happens every time.
Where is it? I think I'm
never going to another Renaissance fair.
Dang, I think I deleted it.
Renaissance. I said Renaissance.
Renaissance.
I think that's the right way to say
it. Really? I think it's in How I Met Your Mother where he makes fun of. Like,
that's what dead. I thought it would be. Have you ever been in the Renaissance Fair?
No.
Well, they have jousting.
Shocker.
It was so funny. It's like
I don't like how you said no, man.
No, you're sincerely asking me. So I'm like,
I'm there telling everyone like, Santa's not real too.
why would you think that I would go?
I don't know.
It's like the whitest thing ever.
Yo, have you never been to the Ren Fair? You've never.
Oh, never even.
You don't know
Hooba
Snake? What do you mean you've never fed a woodland nymph?
What are you talking about?
Do D&D?
Jeez, man.
You've never watched Jousting? So, I don't know right, why I was
going,
like.
What's going
Mike's on board. Mike knows what I'm talking about.
I mean, I'll fool with it. But...
So. I did go in there with the energy
yeah,
of like,
yeah, yeah.
Dude, he
like
knows
you,
exactly what I'm talking
like
about.
You get it. Like,
tell him, Mike. Tell him, Mike.
I thought you were going to finish, like, help me out.
Finish
there.
My sentence for me.
We're about to piggyback the shit.
You know, when they were like jousting? Yes.
Yeah. I'm just like,
bumping mics.
Dude. Yeah, we're about to eat turkey legs.
So, what do you do at this place? Exactly. You watch
I
people.
I want to finish this story.
They just fight? Just
no, not even that. I did, but the Ren Fair.
It's
short for Renaissance. Ugh.
I knew you were doing that. Giving it a nickname.
I'm not. I didn't start fair. That.
Thank God. All right. So what's up with the Ren Fair?
There's a portion of where you can go watch jousting.
Mm. Like real jousting.
No.
Oh.
That's what I thought.
Yeah.
But then you get there and it's basically like. Very long fencing sticks.
Oh.
They just like kind of like and bend
like
and poke them.
Touching each
they
other.
They don't even like get knocked off their horse.
Ugh.
So going into this armored MMA, I was expecting something more like that, like an exhibition type thing. But then they just beat the brakes off each other for like
that sounds fun.
2 hours.
If we could go back to the Ren Faire, what, where was this at?
It's every year. You know the castle on 840?
No. The castle?
There's no way you haven't noticed a castle. You've gone down 840, right? You had to get, no, you went down 65 to get here, didn't you?
Mm-hmm.
And you never took 840.
Mm-mm.
Might be a Smyrna thing.
Was this a famous castle?
Yeah, it's been, I mean, the Renaissance Fair.
You guys know about this? This fair?
What?
Oh.
I mean, I know of
You them, guys don't know about the Renaissance Festival?
The Ren Fair.
The Ren cool. Fair, yeah.
So, wait, you got to give me more. You pay to get in it?
Yeah.
Did you go, tell me you went solo at least.
You went by myself?
Yeah.
I feel like that would be worse.
No, because you found somebody that wanted to do it too?
Man, I mean, hey, personally, I've never been, but.
Wait, what?
No.
Oh, I was about to say.
I'm just trying to get out of this. I would never go to something like that.
When y'all were at that battle bots of people, I messaged Zach and I was like, Matt's doing the pod. Like, should I get him any gifts? And he's like, yeah, get him a toupee. So
funny.
I'm going to let you keep the wings away.
I told him, I was like, if they give me a toupee, I'm walking out of this podcast.
Well, we're at the end anyway.
Yeah.
Oh, man, she is bad.
Yeah, she's awesome.
She makes me feel funny, like climbing up the rope in gym class.
That is a real thing, dude.
Yeah.
Or hanging on the monkey bars, too.
Y'all used to get hard in gym class?
You didn't? I know what you're talking about.
You're about to Renaissance Fair,
though. Oh,
with
my
that.
Gosh. Dude, one time, I don't even know how to say this anymore. It used to be easier to tell this story. A mentally challenged student. Got an erection in gym class and started humping one of the girls while they were doing stretches.
Oh, what did she do?
She tried to get away.
Well, that's a classic mistake.
Yeah,
never try to get away.
Yeah,
also, you have to play dead.
Yeah,
everybody knows that.
You gotta play possum.
Play dead, then you poke them in the eye. Yeah. I'm
sorry. I heard you guys stand up and you have to act bigger than them. You have to spread your arms out and yell, and you have to act. That might be.
That's what you
that
do
might
the
be bears. Yeah. Yeah. Also, that student with the erection was me.
All right.
Wait, are you bald or did you just?
No, I'm bald.
Did you go bald or like?
Yeah, I went bald.
What
I
age?
I wouldn't have did this on purpose.
Thank you.
Yeah.
People are like, every time I see somebody else is bald, they're like, trying to act like we have a connection. Yeah, like, no. I didn't choose this.
Yeah, this was given to me.
Yeah.
You said what age? I don't know, maybe. I went completely bald probably like 5 years ago, I think.
Something what do you mean like completely? That. Like, you still had side hair, right?
Yeah. I mean, it was like thinning up top, and then I had it real, real short.
Yeah. That's a tough transition to like be like finally be like, all right, I gotta let it all go.
Yeah, you at some point you just gotta be like, you know what, this ain't working no more.
Yeah, you guys wouldn't know anything about this struggle.
I'm nervous. Our dad rocks a Friar Tuck, and that's like the worst where it's just like there.
Yeah,
and yeah. Every day I'm always like, it's getting thinner.
It's always knocking at the door.
Oh yeah.
Every I'll comb through this. My hair now, strand falls out. It's like, uh-oh.
Yeah, yeah.
I'll just say this. Let it go before, don't hang on it too long.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Just
you
go
look,
ahead and
you
let
look
it go.
Younger when you shave it off.
Yeah.
If you got, I mean.
Somebody sent me a picture of like,
because
mine was like early 20s. I would say 20 was already noticeable.
Oh, wow.
Yeah, like I shaved my, all right, so.
I mean, it made me feel better, like, shit.
Whenever I was 21, 22, I decided to dress up as a homeless person for Halloween. And there might be a picture on Instagram somewhere. And I shaved, like, a horseshoe in my head.
Mm.
And, like...
Karma.
But long story short, I lost my wallet, got locked out of my house, and my hair never grew back in the same night.
Damn.
So... Big believer.
At least you can find your wallet, you know?
Yeah. Oh, I found my hair. It's on my back.
You were about to say something heartfelt and kind.
Oh, the camera's rolling?
Yeah, we're back.
Never mind. dude, just thank you. This is awesome. Like, I don't know. This is, it's very thoughtful. It means a lot that you guys would like put this much thought into.
I mean, something. Seriously, I can't thank y'all enough. This is like, I mean, I'm totally blown away. I mean, the thought that went into this, or as you said, the creepiness. Either way, this is amazing. I can't thank you guys for doing it, man.
Yeah. It's nice to know that there's a lot of comedy stuff going on in Birmingham. Y'all got your recordings tomorrow. Yeah. We probably won't get this out before then.
Oh, it's fine.
Where can we find y'all, though, on socials?
Oh, I'm at Matt Taylor Comedy on Instagram and TikTok and all that.
Funny Man Mike James, Instagram, and then Funny Man Mike J on Facebook.
Don't do TikTok. But if you look up our names on either one of them, it's going to take a minute to find us.
Yeah, don't. Yeah.
You might find the other comedians first.
That'll be crazy.
What are we going to do about this?
Yeah. Oh, God. What a thing to ask.
Yeah. Well, thanks for coming on our little public access TV show here.
This is awesome, great.
Man. Yeah. Absolutely
I love it.
Awesome. Party love on, man.
Hey, party on, Wayne.
Party on, guard.
Yeah, you should do that. What do I need to say? Party on? Yeah, party on.
Party on,
Look, I'm more master disguise. I'm not impressionist.
Yeah, okay? Turtle.